Good morning, children. I hope you have revised whatever we have done till today. The nth term of an AP, AN as A plus N minus 1 into D, and the sum of first N terms of an AP, SN, is equal to N by 2 into 2A plus N minus 1 into D, or N by 2 into A plus AN, where AN represents the last term. Let's proceed with question number 15 from exercise 5.3. A contract on construction job specifies a penalty for delay of completion beyond a certain date as Rs. 200 for the first day, Rs. 250 for the second day, Rs. 300 for the third day, and so on. The penalty for each day being Rs. 50 more than the preceding day. That means how much money the contractor has to pay as penalty if he has delayed the work by 30 days. That means if the work is to be completed, or the work has to be completed on a specific day, and if the work is incomplete, the first day the contractor has to pay 200 rupees as penalty. Then the second day he has to pay another 250. The third day he has to pay another 300. Like that, if he is paying for 30 days, what is the total of the penalty money? That is what we are supposed to find out. So here the number of days is 30. First term A is 200, and the difference is 250 minus 200, which is equal to 50 rupees. That means the first day 200 plus, first day plus second day is 200 plus 250. First day, second day, third day together is 200 plus 250 plus 300, etc. That is why the sum of 30 days is involved. So SN is equal to N by 2, 2A plus N minus 1 into D. That is for 30 days. So 30 by 2 into 2 into 200 plus 30 minus 1 into D is 50. That is 30 by 2 into 400 plus 29 into 50. 30 by 2 into 400 plus 9 5s are 45, 5 2s are 10, 14, 1450. Or 30 by 2 into 1850, 925. 5 3s are 15, 1. 2 3s are 6, 7, 9 3s are 27. That means a total of 27,750 has to be paid as penalty by the contractor for that particular construction job as penalty, because he did not complete the work on time. Question number 16. A sum of Rs. 700. Underline the word sum. A sum of Rs. 700 is to be given as 7 cash prizes to students of a school. Again, underline the word 7, for their overall academic performance. If each prize is 20 less than its preceding prize, find the value of each prize. That means a sum of Rs. 700 is to be given, which shows that SN is Rs. 700 is to be divided among 7 prizes, and each price is 20 less than, means the common difference is given as 20. You have to find out the value of those 7 prizes. Even if you take D as negative 20, the answer will be correct, because the prices will be in the descending order of the denomination. You can take D as both positive or negative. SN is equal to N by 2 into 2a plus l minus 1 into d, 700 is equal to 7 by 2 into 2a plus 7 minus 1 into 20, cross multiplying, 1400 is equal to 7 into 2a plus 120, that is 6 into 20. 1400 divided by 7 is equal to 2a plus 120. 200 minus 120 is equal to 2a, or 80 is equal to 2a, or a is equal to 40. That means the first term, the prices are, the 7 prices are, the first price is rupees 40. They are all in rupees. The next is rupees 60, because 40 plus 20 is 60. Then rupees 80, rupees 100, rupees 120, rupees 140, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and rupees 160. So the 7 prices are in this order. If you take D as negative 20, you will be getting the first amount as rupees 160, then it will be in the decreasing order, but the price amounts are rupees 40 to rupees 160. Question number 17. In a school, students thought of planting trees in and around the school to reduce air pollution. It was decided that the number of trees that each section of each class will plant will be the same as that of the class, that is, a section of class 1 will plant 1 tree, section of class 2 will plant 2 trees, and so on till 12. There are 3 sections of each class. How many trees will be planted by the students? See, the condition is, if the first standard students will plant only 1 plant, this is the class and this is the number of plants. Second standard students, each section will plant 2 plants. Third standard, each section 3 plants, like that. 12th standard will plant 12 plants, but these are the number of plants per section. That means one section, what are the number of plants they are going to plant? That is how the number is given to you. Now, it is said that there are 3 sections of each class. So, what will be the total plants? It is, the AP will be, it is 1 into 3. There are 3 sections. 2 into 3 is 6. 3 threes are 9, etc. 12 threes are 36. We are asked to find out the sum of all these plants total. So what will be the AP? The AP is 3, 6, 9, etc. up to 36. And there are 12 sections. The number of n is equal to 12. How do you find out? Sn is equal to n by 2 into, here you can use the formula a plus an, since a is also known to you, an is also known to you, a plus an, that is 12 by 2, there are 12 standards, so 12 by 2 into 3 plus 36, 6 into 39, 9 6 are 54, 5, 6 3s are 18 plus 5, 234 plants. That means the total plants will be 234 by 3 sections of each standard. You can call this as standard, that will be more appropriate. Question number 18. A spiral is made up of successive semicircles with centers alternatively as A, B, starting with center A of radii 0.5 cm, 1 cm, 1.52 as shown in the figure. What is the total length of such spiral made up of 13 consecutive semicircles? So the picture is shown in the next page. That means the center of the spiral is given to you. The center is A, the first spiral of, you can see the radius is given as 0.5 centimeter, and then the next spiral from A, the diameter is 1 centimeter. From the center, 1.5 centimeter. That is how the spiral has been made. And there are 13 rounds here, which shows that n is equal to 13. You are asked to find out the total length of the spiral. So when you look into the figure, the curve you can see here, or the spiral, is in the shape of a semicircle. What is the circumference of a semicircle? Circumference of a semicircle is pi r. That is 2 pi r divided by 2, or it is pi r. Let's leave pi as pi, pi into the first semicircle you can see as 0.5. What is the length of the second semicircle? It is pi into, here you can see the radius is 1. What is the length of the third semicircle? It is pi into 1.5. Length of first semicircle, 0.5 pi, 1 pi, 1.5 pi, etc. So what is the arithmetic progression? The progression is 0.5 pi, 1 pi, 1.5 pi, etc. There are 13 semicircles. You are asked to find out the total length of it, means the SN formula has to be applied. N is equal to 13 and S13 has to be found out. So S13 is equal to 13 by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d, which is equal to 13 by 2 into 2 into a is 0.5 pi plus 13 minus 1 is 12 into d is again 1 minus 1 pi minus 0.5 pi means again 0.5 pi, or it is the same as 13 by 2 into, what is 2 into 0.5? It is 1. 1 pi plus 12 into 0.5. What is 12 into 0.5? Half of 12 is 6. So it is 6 pi, which is the same as 13 by 2 into 1 pi plus 6 pi means 7 pi. Or final answer is 13 by 2, 7 into 22 by 7, 7, 7 gets cancelled, 2 and 22 gets cancelled, or 13 into 11, 1, 3 is 3, 1, 3, 1. It is 143 centimeter. That means the total length of the spiral in the form of semicircles is 143 centimeter. Question number 19. 200 logs are stacked in the following manner. You can see the word 200 logs are stacked in the following manner, and the picture shows that there is a total of 200 logs. That means the SN is given as 200. There are 200 logs. 20 logs in the bottom row. Then 19 in the next row, 18 in the row next to it, and so on. That means the below most or the bottom row has 20 logs. Then in the decreasing order, 20, 18, etc. There are a total of 200 and they are asking you how many rows are there, as well as what is the number of rows, number of logs in the first or the top row, what you are seeing. That means you have to calculate N. When SN is given to you and N has to be calculated, you already know that it may go into quadratic equations. So SN is equal to N by 2 into 2A plus N minus 1 into D. 200 is equal to N by 2 into 2 into 20 plus N minus 1 into D is 19 minus 20, because it is negative 1, because it's coming in a decreasing order. Cross multiplying, 400 is equal to N into 40 minus N plus 1. 400 is equal to N into 41 minus N. Let's form the quadratic. 400 is equal to 41N minus N square, or N square minus 41N plus 400 is equal to 0. Let's proceed with the D method. A is equal to 1, B is equal to minus 41, C is equal to 400, D is equal to B square minus 4AC, minus 41 the whole square minus 4 into 1 into 400. What is 41 into 41? 1, 4 is 4, 4 4s are 16, or it is 1681 minus 1600 is 81. Root D is 9. Root 81 is 9. Therefore, N is equal to, that means alpha is equal to, minus B plus root D by 2A. The first value has 41 plus 9 by 2, 50 by 2, which is equal to 25, or N is equal to minus B minus root D by 2A, which is equal to 41 minus 9 by 2. 41 minus 9 is 32 by 2, which is equal to 16. Now you got two positive values for N, one is 25 and one is 16. So which one will be the correct number of rows? Is it 25 or are there 16 rows? Let's see, if N is equal to 25, what is AN or A25? Is A plus 24D, which is equal to, A value is 20 plus 24 into D value is negative 1, 20 minus 24, which shows that there are minus 4, that means there are minus 4 logs, which is not a sensible answer, which shows that N is equal to 25 is not the correct answer. Let's check whether N is equal to, double check whether N equal to 16 or there are 16 rows. A N is equal to, A 16 is equal to A plus 15D, which is equal to 20 plus 15 into minus 1, 20 minus 15, which is equal to 5 logs. It shows that the top row, the first row, will have 5 logs. Number of logs in the top or first row is equal to 5, and number of rows is equal to 16. That is how you will understand the question. Question number 20. In a potato race, a bucket is placed at the starting point, which is 5 meters from the first potato, and other potatoes are placed 3 meters apart in a straight line. There are 10 potatoes in the line. A competitor starts from the bucket picks up the nearest potato and runs back to it, drops it, comes back and takes the second one and drops it. She continues in the same way until all the potatoes are in the bucket. What is the total distance the competitor has to run? So there is an empty basket here. The potatoes are placed, the first one, the second one, the third one, so on. The distance from the potato, the first one is only 5 meter, the remaining all 3 meters apart. Now, the girl is standing in this position, first position. She runs to the first potato, picks it and comes back. That means in the first trial, she has taken 5 meter plus 5 meter. That means 10 meter she has covered. Now again the girl is in the starting position. She runs to the second potato. That means 5 plus 3, 8 meter. Runs back with that and drops it. 16 meter. So the third one again. 8 plus 3, 11, and 11 plus 11, 22 meter, and so on. That means the AP is 10, 16, 22, etc. There are 10 potatoes in line. That means N is equal to 10. You have to find out the total distance she has covered in bringing all the potatoes back into this bucket. So, A is equal to 10, B is equal to 6, N is equal to 10, and you have to find out what is SN. What's SN formula? N by 2 into 2A plus N minus 1 into D, which is equal to 10 by 2 into 2 into 10 plus 10 minus 1 into 6 or 5 into 20 plus 9 sixes are 54. 5 into 74, 5 fours are 20, 35 plus 2, 370 meter. That means the total distance covered is equal to 370 meter. Exercise is over, but then exercise 5.4 optional first question is very important. Let's do that. Which term of the AP? 121. 117, 113 is the first negative term. The AP is given as 121, 117, 113, etc. When you look into the pattern of the AP, you can understand that it is a decreasing AP, which shows that in one of the positions, the first negative term starts. They are asking you which is the first negative term or which position will give you the first negative term. So let us take the answer as let the nth term be the first negative term. That means we normally call the nth term by an, and negative term in maths means it's a quantity which is below zero. That is, let an be the first negative term, that is an is smaller than zero, a plus n minus 1 into d smaller than zero, a is 121 plus n minus 1 into d is 117 minus 121, which is negative 4, is smaller than 0. 121 minus 4n plus 4 smaller than 0. 125 minus 4n smaller than 0. There are two ways of solving this, or there are two methods by which you can get the value of n. The first method is you will shift 4n to the right side, which give you the inequality. 125 smaller than positive 4n, or you will write as 4n is greater than 125, which gives you the same result. That is n greater than 125 by 4, n greater than 31.10, 2, etc. We know that n is a natural number, or it should be a perfect natural number. Therefore, the number which is just above 31.2 is 32, or 32nd term is the first negative term. Or another way of proving is, you can arrange as minus 4n smaller than minus 125. Now, you should not cancel the negative symbol in inequality. You will change it as 4n less than will become greater than minus 125 will become positive 125. It gives the same answer as 31.2, etc. Or the 32nd term is the first negative term. In the 32nd position, you will get the first negative term. So, this is a very important 3-mark question. And so, you can practice all the questions which are done in the textbook, as well as you can practice the worked out examples too in the lesson Arithmetic Progression.